If you're looking to get started with automation here in 2022, specifically Airtable automation, this is 100% the first video you should be watching. In this video, I'm going to be breaking down for newbies how you can start to think about automation using Airtable. So we're going to be actually building an automation from scratch, but we do that in a lot of our videos. What we're doing here is going through the overall thought process, the building blocks that you need in order to build successful automation. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I am the owner at Gap Consulting, and I'm going to help you save up to 20 hours per week per person on your team leveraging the power of no-code automation. If you want to learn more about that, I have actually put together a webinar presentation for you. You can sign up for free. You can register for that at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. I'll include that link below this video in the description so that you can find it quickly. But without further ado, let's hop into the heart of this video and actually walk through the building blocks of automation so that you can start thinking as a programmer. And the best part is we're going to do all of this without a single line of code. You don't have to know how to code in order to get these kind of results. So first we have to understand what we're going to be doing with our automation. This is the starting point 100% of the time, and it makes me laugh when people try to skip it. Think about this. Can you possibly tell a computer what to do if you can't define the process yourself? Of course, the answer is no. A computer can only do what we can articulate. So spend time thinking about your outline and what you need to do for your automation before you just start building, because you're going to wind up building stuff you probably don't need if you try to skip this step. So our automation is going to be really simple. We just want to take a project when a certain status is marked and we want to send a welcome email. Let's hop on into my base here and I'll show you how we've structured the overall database. Now we have two parts, contacts and projects. Contacts is really straightforward. It's a name and an email address. And then we have a link to the projects. On the projects table, we have obviously the reciprocal of that link. If a client is linked to a project, the project is also linked to the client. But we have this status here. What phase or stage is this particular project in? We also have a start date, and then we have a start date pretty. And this is just a formula where I'm taking that start date and I'm outputting it in a nicer format. In this case, the full month, a day, and the year. I feel like this is a little bit easier to read, and you'll see why I want this in just a moment. So, how do we send out this email? Well, we've got these different status: discovery, onboarding send email, onboarding send work agreement, onboarding invoice, development, this is the actual project work itself, and then completed. Now these stages, the status that I'm using here is completely adjustable. Whatever it is for you is, you know, your own process. This is just an imaginary workflow, and the idea here is that when a status is changed to send email, then we need to send an email. Simple enough. Of course, at the end of that, we then want to move it into the next stage because we've now completed this part of the process. So then as an amendment to our automation, we're going to change the status and move it to the next status as well. Now we can do all of this right here inside of Airtable using automation. And the thing you need to know in starting out building automation, two key building blocks for any automation: trigger and actions. A trigger is simply the set of conditions that activate the automation and tell it to wake up and perform its magic. And then the actions are those things that the automation is programmed to do. So in our case, if we were just speaking about this plainly, we would say, well, listen, when I move this particular project into the onboarding send email status or stage, then I want my automation to send an email and then move it out of this stage or status into onboarding work agreement. That's easy enough to say in words, so let's now build it with automation. In the upper right corner, we're going to set up our automation. We're going to build one from scratch and create a custom automation. And here we go. First piece, like I mentioned, is that trigger. The trigger I really like to use a lot inside of Airtable is a record matching conditions. But you'll notice that you have a bunch of different options here. You can even trigger automations using third-party tools like Google or Outlook. So definitely explore this, because as Airtable unlocks more automation, you'll see more and more options showing up here. Webhooks are a bit on the coding side of things. They are very, very versatile, very flexible tools. But for this, we're keeping it simple for newbies. So we're gonna say record matches conditions. What are those conditions? Well, first, we have to tell it where this data lives. And this data lives in our projects table. That is where the status exists that we're looking for. So we have to make the right selection from the table perspective. And now we want to set forth those conditions. And the biggest part of these conditions is that the status is equal to send email. But that in and of itself is not sufficient, because we want to make sure that we have an email to send to. Over time, as you start to experience more automation, you're going to learn that there are a lot of these little hacks or fail-safes that you can put into your automation to prevent it from erroring out. One of those is, I want to make sure that I have all the information I could possibly imagine that I'm going to need for this particular automation. And in this case, I need an email address. Let's go back to our database and actually look to see where that email address is. And you'll notice it doesn't yet exist in our projects table. But our project record is the one that's going to be initiating the automation. So we really need to make sure that we have the proper data here. Now, the data lives at the client level, but we can look it up using a lookup field. So we're going to bring in an email field for the client. We don't want to type it up every single time. We already know this client's email, so we use this special field type. And we tell it that we want to look at the client, and we want to reach down a layer and pull back data that belongs to the client. In this case, email. So I grab that email, and I create the field, and there it is. The email for this client is immediately showing up here because I've properly linked it. And if this link ever breaks, then the email goes away as well. So now that we have this set up, this is now the condition that we want. So we're going to go back into our automation and we're going to add additional conditions here. So I want to ensure that yes, I have an email. So I say the email is not empty, because if email is empty, why in the world would I trigger an automation to send an email? That is a broken automation. Lastly, I'm going to make sure that I have a date. Specifically, my start date pretty is not empty. Now, if I don't have a date for this project, but I want to include the date in the body of my email, it's a little ridiculous to send that email knowing that I don't have all the information. So build really good triggers for yourself to ensure that your automations only fire when you're good and ready for them to go. Now, the next step here is to go back to our actual data and make sure that we have a record that meets the conditions that we just built. So you'll notice that this particular record here has the right status, it has an email in the email field, and it has a date. So when I perform a search here, I will go back into my automation and I'll run a test. And Airtable is actually going to look and it's going to see if it can identify a record that meets the conditions that we just set up. And yeah, it does successfully. We get this green checkbox. You want to make sure that you get this green checkbox before moving on. Otherwise, you might have something broken in the way that you set up your conditions. Now, let's move on and build our action step. The first thing we want to do is send an email. So I'm going to scroll on down, go to Gmail here, and we'll select send email as my first action. Remember, an action is the thing that the automation is going to do once it is awakened. Here it is. I'm going to send an email. And everywhere that there's an asterisk here, I have to fill this information out. Before I get to that, I better link up my Gmail account. Now, I've already set up my account, so I can just select it here. But if you have multiple accounts, you can manage them here or connect new accounts here as well. Now that I'm set up, I can go ahead and say who I'm going to send this to. And the person I want to send it to is, of course, the email address that we captured in the first part of this automation. In this trigger, we looked up that email address and made sure that it existed before moving on. So we're going to use that email address here. In order to get access to it, I need to look here at all the things that have happened previously in my automation. And so far, there's only one step. It's the step that triggered the automation. I can expand that, and I get to see everything that exists inside of that record that triggered the automation. And in this case, I want to look for that email address. Now, it's a lookup field, and we don't see any information right here, but I can continue drill in a little bit deeper, and you see I get all these different properties for this email. I have the length, I have the linked record ID, and I have the value. It's the email value that I want to use here. So I'm going to insert that, and I can type up a subject. Let's say new project kickoff. And I can say my message here as well. Looking forward to getting started. Now here I want to bring in the actual schedule date for this particular automation or this particular project. And the thing is that this is always changing. You'll notice a difference here between static and dynamic data. Static data is that data that's going to be the same every time the automation performs. This body of the email was typed out. It's going to always be the same. This subject line also typed out. It will always be the same. But the email here was inserted dynamically based on the record that triggered the automation. And so this is dynamic data because it's going to change every time the automation runs. This will be a different value. So my scheduled date is also a different value every time. Let's bring in some dynamic data here. I'll access the record again. I can scroll on down. And here is where I'm going to insert the pretty version of that start date. Now, sure, I could use the regular start date here, but it really doesn't read as well as having the nicely formatted start date that I pointed out at the beginning. So I'm going to pop that in here, hit a period to close out that sentence, give it a little signature, sign off on this email. I can include attachments if I want, and then I'm going to run a test. Before doing this, though, I'm going to check out the preview, and this is what's going to happen. This is who's going to receive it. This is the subject, and that's the body of the email. Nice little preview feature. I'm happy with the way that looks. So I run a test, and I should get the green checkbox in just a moment. I can always pop into my email, refresh my email, open it up, and I see that that just sent 0 minutes ago. Everything looks great. So heading back into my automation, if you recall, I'm almost done. But the last step is to update the stage or the status of this project and move it into the next step. So let's do that. Before we do, I want to look and make sure I get exactly verbatim what this next stage looks like. It's onboarding dash work agreement, all caps for the beginning of these words. Because this is static data again. Every time the automation runs, I want it to update with the same status. So I better get that spelling 100%. Dropping back into my automation, I can add an additional action here. You can have unlimited actions inside of your automation. The idea here is that it's going to do all the things that you want to do in one automated process. So I'm going to update a record. What record? And this is where people often get confused. I want to update the same record that I had that initiated this automation. So of course it's going to be a record in the projects table because that's what initiated the automation. And the best way to make sure that you're updating the right record is to use the record ID. Now, this is metadata that you and I probably don't see or think of much, but Airtable thinks of records by these unique IDs. Clicking on continue here, you'll see that ID at the very top of this record from the first step. So in the first step, we had a record that was ready to automate, ready to have that email sent. And so that is the ID that we captured in that step. Use that record ID, even though it looks like gibberish to you, that is fine. Airtable thinks of that and it knows exactly what record that is. Any fields that you need to make adjustments to, you'll simply come in and make said adjustments here. And in this case, I'm updating this to onboarding work agreement. Now, if you misspell something here or just don't line it up exactly right as your status, you might run into a bit of a snag and find that you actually create a new single select field. If that happens, no problem. Just come back in and make the changes here. But let's test it and make sure we got it right. I'm going to run a test. I should get the green checkbox. I can go back out here and I see that yes, in fact, this status was updated. So I am pretty happy with the way this is working. When you build automations, don't wrap it up here. Make sure you name the automation to stay organized. Send email and update status. And lastly, we're going to turn this on. Now, from here, anytime we have a record in our database that meets our predetermined conditions, it's going to send out that email and then update the status to the next part of the process. So for this, I'm going to use a Kanban view. I like the Kanban view a lot for tracking progress over a project. So I'm going to line these up by status. And you see that this maintains the order of the different stages inside of my project. I can close down my automations panel. This is going to work in the background. That's the beauty of automation. And let's set up a new project. I'm going to connect to the same client or the same contact because I don't want to send spam email to anybody. I can set up a start date. Remember, I need to have a start date in order for this automation to fire. So I've selected a start date for the project. And of course, I also need for there to be an email. And since I picked a client that has an email, that came in as well. And I'm ready to go here. When this project moves into this stage, that will trigger the automation to send an email and then move it into the next stage. Let's go ahead and move this one over here to complete it so we can watch this particular project move on its own thanks to the automation. I drop it here, sit back. It won't take long for that automation to fire, and you see it just moved over to work agreement. And if I were to go back to my inbox right now, I can go ahead and refresh, and I'm going to have a fresh new email here. I will select that, and we know this is a different project because the date matches up with the new project I just set up. I hope this has you spinning with possibilities because automation is an incredibly powerful tool. And if you're just starting out with Airtable, your mind is going to be blown when you learn about all the time you can save. As I told you at the beginning, I do have that free webinar training. Do check it out if you want to get a deeper dive in automations, and I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program, and for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.